Hello and welcome to your biology class. Today we are going to study about the DNA, and basically let's start with the full form of DNA. What is DNA? DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid, and it is just an elder brother to the ribonucleic acid. So there is a difference in the name. Nucleic acid is same, but because both of these are responsible for controlling the genetics of a cell. But why deoxy and not deoxy, which is normal ribo? The answer lies in the sugar, the pentose sugar, which is the backbone of the DNA. Now see, this is a DNA. The structure I have made are the helix, and the helix are just long chains of these sugars. Now these sugars are having five carbons, one carbon on first prime, on second prime, third prime, fourth prime, and fifth prime. All of the carbons that are present are concluded as primes, and these primes are very much responsible. Sole responsibility of giving a DNA helix orientation. Ek जो sugar present है उसमें जो भी primes present है उन्हीं का काम होता है एक डीएनए को ओरिएंटेशन प्रोवाइड करना, कि हम बोलते हैं डीएनए हेलिक्स इज 5 प्राइम टू 3 प्राइम. तो ये चीज हम बाद में देखेंगे कि क्या है, बट ये रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी सिर्फ और सिर्फ इस शुगर पे डिपेंड करती है. ओके, दिस 1 प्राइम कार्बन. नाउ द मेन थिंग विच आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट, जिसके बारे में मैं अभी बात कर रहा था, दैट डीऑक्सी एंड ऑक्सी, ये सारा खेल यहां पर होता है. दो प्राइम यानी सेकंड प्राइम पे नॉर्मली एक OH प्रेजेंट है. इन नॉर्मल शुगर द OH इज प्रेजेंट, बट इफ द OH इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय ओनली हाइड्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन इज रिमूव्ड, देन इट इज नाउ नोन एज डीऑक्सी. एंड एज सून एज द ऑक्सीजन इज रिमूव्ड, दिस शुगर मॉइटी is much more stable, so to provide the final stability to the DNA as compared to the RNA. Okay, and I was talking about the helix. Now we have the nitrogenous bases. Now DNA is completely formed of three main things. One is nitrogenous base that you can see, the purines and pyrimidines. One is the sugar, pentose sugar. And third thing is the phosphate. Okay, the phosphate which is responsible for the binding. Now this structure, the structure I have told you is made by the sugars, but the sugar which is present upwards and sugar which is present downwards is connected by the phosphate, and that is third important thing for making a DNA polymer. Clear? Now talking about the nitrogenous base. The nitrogenous base are purines and pyrimidines. As you can see the structure, there is a hexose and a pentose ring. एक हेक्सागन और एक पेंटागन. नाउ बिकॉज ऑफ द कार्बन प्रेजेंट ऑन फर्स्ट प्राइम, थर्ड प्राइम, सॉरी फर्स्ट पोजीशन, थर्ड पोजीशन, नाइन्थ एंड सेवेंथ एंड नाइन्थ पोजीशन, दिस मेक्स प्यूरिन. एंड द नाइट्रोजन प्रेजेंट ऑन थर्ड एंड फर्स्ट पोजीशन मेक्स अ पाइरिमिडिन. नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द purines and pyrimidines in detail, the cytosine and the thiamine. सी टॉकिंग अबाउट द आरएनए एंड डीएनए डिफरेंस, मैं जब आरएनए और डीएनए के डिफरेंस की बात करता हूं तो सिर्फ इतना ही नहीं कि इस ओएच से एक ऑक्सीजन रिमूव हो जाएगा और डीएनए आरएनए में कन्वर्ट हो जाएगा, नहीं, ये जो यूरेसिल है, नाउ दिस यूरेसिल इज ऑल्सो एन इंपॉर्टेंट नाइट्रोजिनस बेस दैट इज ओनली प्रेजेंट ऑन आरएनए एंड डज नॉट इवन हैव अ सिंगल चांस ऑफ प्रेजेंस ऑन डीएनए. दिस यूरेसिल इज जस्ट चेंज इट्स ओरिएंटेशन, चेंज इट्स शेप विद द थायामिन. नाउ थायामिन एंड यूरेसिल आर टू थिंग्स. थायामिन इज नॉट प्रेजेंट ऑन आरएनए एंड यूरेसिल इज नॉट प्रेजेंट ऑन डीएनए. व्हाट इज द कंपैरिजन बिटवीन दीज टू, आई विल टेल यू लेटर. नाउ वी हैव द पायरिमिडिन्स. द पायरिमिडिन्स आर एडेनिन एंड ग्वानिन. द पायरिमिडिन्स आर एडेनिन एंड ग्वानिन विच आर अस सिंगल हेलिकल सिंगल हेक्सो स्ट्रक्चर, सिंगल हेक्सागन स्ट्रक्चर. And these are the nitrogenous bases that are present in DNA. We have talked about all three. The phosphate group, the pentose sugar, and also the purine and pyrimidines. Now, there was a person who was named, who was Chargaff. No, before Chargaff, let's see about who find out the DNA. There was a man called Frederick Mischer, and that Frederick Mischer was responsible for giving its name, its precursor name, not actual name, its precursor name to the DNA, as he saw the DNA present in the nucleus and he named it nuclein. ये बातें 1869 की हैं. इट वॉज फ्रेडरिक मिशर, ही नेम्ड इट न्यूक्लीन. लेटर ऑन बिकॉज ऑफ एसिडिक नेचर इट वॉज कंक्लूडेड दैट इट इज अ न्यूक्लिक एसिड. नाउ इफ यू आस्क व्हाई द डीएनए इज एसिडिक इन नेचर, the reason behind this is phosphate. Now, because of presence of phosphate, the DNA is acidic in nature. Okay? Then comes a person, Chargaff, and he gave a principle. Now, he gave a rule, a principle, which means that purine will always bind with the pyrimidine so which one were purines A and G and which of the rest three are pyrimidines, it was cytosine, there was thymine and there was uracil. So purine always binds with pyrimidine and adenine always binds with thymine. Guanine always binds with cytosine, thymine or uracil. Clear? So this was concluded by the man Chargaff. Chargaff told that the amount of DNA, amount of purines will always be the amount equal to the pyrimidines. Jitne bhi purines present hain, utne hi pyrimidines present honge. Agar main ek DNA normal ki baat karta hoon aur uske andar 50% purines hain, to it is sure shot that pyrimidines will also be 50% or otherwise the DNA cannot stay stable. Okay? The DNA will not stay stable if I If I change it to 55% in ratio with 45%, then the DNA will not be stable. There are some mutations present in the DNA. He also gave that there is a double bond present between the adenine and thymine, and there is a triple bond present between the guanine and cytosine. This is universal in every organism. Having DNA as genetic material will be having this kind of structure. Clear with this? Now, adenine and thymine have one OH bond, and second, they have one nitrogen hydrogen bond. These two are the bonds which are present now. One bond is OH and second is NH. Then we have the guanine and cytosine, and these have two OH bonds and they have one NH bond. Now this triple bonding is not between as we see that if a carbon is making a triple bond with anything. I'm not a chemist and don't even know about the bonding, but I'll make you understand. The carbon, it is making bond with another carbon and having one H and H. Now this is not that type of bonding. These are hydrogen bonds, and these hydrogen bonds are mediated by these hydrogens, but these are between different groups. Okay, now talking about the percentage, there is a question that is very much asked in the NEET. If a DNA is having 20% of adenine, find out the percentage of cytosine. What percent? That will be solved as, if our DNA is having adenine 20%, which means it is double bonded with the guanine, which is also 20% according to the Chargaff's rule. The total two, which are, it is thymine. The total two making 20% of purine and 20% of pyrimidine gives 40%. Now if these 40% of the DNA is having A and T only, then rest of the 60% will be G triple bonded C. And I have asked you the question, what is the percentage of C? Then dividing this 60% by 2, it is 30%. Now 30% cytosine is present as salt. So this is a little logical concept about the Chargaff's rule. Now talking about the bondings present in a DNA, then we can see the structure. There are three total bonds present in DNA. These three total bonds are, first, phosphodiester. Which is present between the 3 prime to 5 prime, or you can take it vice versa, between the pentose sugar of DNA helix. Second we have is glycosidic bond. What are glycosidic bonds? These glycosidic bonds are when any carbohydrate making the bonding with doesn't matter, it is one is carbohydrate, doesn't matter another one is a protein or amino acid or fatty acid or anything, but the glycosidic bond is always between a carbohydrate and carbon of another kind of entity. Okay, let's सेटल डाउन इट विद द एंटिटी, हम इसे एंटिटी से जस्ट समझौता कर लेते हैं. सो इट इज ग्लाइकोसिडिक बॉन्ड. द थर्ड वी हैव इज हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड्स, एंड दीज ग्लाइकोसिडिक बॉन्ड्स आर प्रेजेंट बिटवीन द शुगर एंड द नाइट्रोजिनस बेस. Where the hydrogen bonds are present? Hydrogen bonds are present in nitrogenous bases. Okay? When all of these three bonds combine together, the DNA forms. But there are some terminology that is previous to the DNA formation. And those terminologies are one, nucleoside, and second, nucleotide. Nucleoside and nucleotide. Now, this is the last topic. उसके बाद ये वीडियो एंड करते हैं और बाकी का जो बॉन्डिंग होगी, जो एक्चुअल स्ट्रक्चर होगा, उसके मेजरमेंट्स होंगे, डीएनए के टाइप्स होंगे या कुछ भी चीज, आप लोग इस वीडियो पे कमेंट करके मुझे बता सकते हैं कि अगला वीडियो आपको किस चीज का चाहिए. और आई विल ट्राई माय लेवल बेस्ट टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम टीचिंग. दीज न्यूक्लियोसाइड्स एंड न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स आर व्हेनेवर वन नाइट्रोजिनस बेस इज अटैच्ड टू द शुगर बॉन्ड, attached to the sugar moiety, is known as a nucleoside. Now the bonding between these two is only the glycosidic. When one nitrogen bond, one nitrogenous base plus sugar plus phosphate. Now, if the phosphate attaches to these two, then it is a nucleotide. Now, we have the glycosidic bond and we also have the phosphodiester bond. Two bondings are there, and if hydrogen bond also includes in that, that is known as a base pair. That is known as a base pair. One nitrogen base plus one sugar plus phosphate, and this is bonded with the nitrogenous base of this side with sugar and with phosphate. Now this is a question, which nitrogenous bases I am referring here. With this question, I hope you all understood what I have taught about. Thank you so much. Just like and subscribe the channel so that to see the next part and to motivate with a comment whether you like the video or not, and that will be helpful for me for preparing to my next videos. Thank you so much, everyone. See you later.